What's up, guys? I figured this week I'd go over my gear bag here. So, as you can see, Pro Athletics made a pretty awesome New York Lizards bag for me a couple years ago. Unlike the ones we get from New Balance that fall apart in about 4 days, this one's lasted me a while, which I love. So, first things first, we got our New York Lizards helmet, Cascade, the best helmet on the planet.
Introducing the Cascade S.
I've only worn Cascade. I have no interest in trying on any other helmet. I feel like when you're already wearing the best helmet that looks the best and feels the best, then what's the point?
I rock Maverick pads. I love the Maverick pads. They're my favorite. I put them on and was able to use them the day I had them. They have a broken in feel. I've always been a guy who cuts his palms out, but this year I'm kind of sticking with the Oxway palms because they're just so soft, they break in real quick. I like wearing all white when I go on the road, and when I'm at home, I have the exact same set, but black. Especially Atlanta this weekend, forget it. I'm definitely gonna wear all white, try and stay nice and cool. The New Balance Freeze are the best cleats that I've ever worn. Even with a broken foot, I was able to play. The big thing that I changed in the off season for me were these insoles. These Victory insoles are awesome. They got a carbon fiber base, and you can get them in different rigidity. So it can either be really hard or it can be less rigid, which is pretty cool. And you can literally feel yourself bounce while you run.
You're a real face-off guy. You know what this is. Knee pads are crucial. The Tribe 7 ones are the best on earth. I like to double up. I wear them on the left and the right because I have what's called shingivitis. Take a look at this. And when it gets hot out, when it's summertime, all of these scars all over my shins light up and they get like pink looking. So that's attractive. Story of my life, I'm Greg Beast. I have ugly shins and that's the way I live. I'm an ugly monster.
I'm a guy who has always used for at least a decade now the Warrior Blade, the OG. I used to use the Blade, the OG Blade, and then they stopped making it because they were weird, and then they started making the Blade OG again, which is great. Same exact shape, it just cracks a little different. The old one used to kind of just crack and the whole head would break into pieces. Now this one just kind of tears, so I basically go through one of these a game. I use Hero Mesh, black Hero Mesh, every single game. Everyone knows that. It's kind of an FO Army thing, so all the FOA guys use black Hero Mesh, which is really cool. We have our FOA ball stops that we use. I like to string locks up here all through the top and then down to where the shooting string ends. So right here, right underneath the last shooting string is where I stop using the interlocks. And then usually I'll just wrap the sidewalls here so that the pocket can sway back and forth. And it's a common theme. Guys use super tight sidewalls, but then the ball gets stuck because it basically takes away a diamond. So what you want to do is you want to ease up, either make your sidewalls looser or just wrap it for a couple holes just so it's nice and loose and the pocket can sway back and forth. Make it tight here and tight here. That way the ball won't get stuck. Which brings me to my next point. For the first time ever, I'm using the Dual 2. So, you know, it's funny, STX Dual came out and I trashed it. But I used it in the off season to try and work with my college guys to give them better looks. And I used the Dual because that's the head they're gonna be seeing most of the time, either that or a Nike CEO. In the league, we can't even use Nike heads, so I really thought it would be worthless for me to use it. So I used a head that I could use and that they're gonna see, and that's the Dual. And I got used to it. And I understand it's pros and cons. It is wiry, it bends like crazy, but I'll tell you what, this will last you at least six of the blades because the blades will crack. These will just warp. And what you gotta do is you just gotta jam a ball stop in there. So if you get like, you know, a softball or something, you just jam it in there while you're on the sideline just to keep it wide. The problem is it gets really flimsy in the middle. The strength of this head is it collapses. That's the bad thing of the head as well, because then you gotta scoop ground balls in the heat, and I have no idea how this head's gonna react when I'm playing in hot weather. However, the scoop is 10 times better than the blade. The blade has an awful scoop, everyone knows it. But the head works and it's great, and guys, you know, get their hands closer to the ball, so it's got its pros and cons. The other part of it that I started using last year is this lizard skin tape. I love this stuff. The main benefit of this stuff isn't that it's super grippy or tacky. It's just that it's gonna stop your hand from getting face-off hand. So all the guys who have calluses here as face-off guys, I am able to play without glove palms if I wanted to, and I'll never tear my hand open. This stuff is like a pad. It's fantastic. It's not bulky. It's not super tacky. It just, it feels like tape and it stops your hand. It's like a pillow for your hand, which is great. I'm lucky because Lizard Skin sent me some neon pink stuff. I'm gonna be doing the breast cancer awareness for May, trying to raise money for that. Obviously, when you're on the road, especially me, because I train every day and I beat myself up when I play. So we got some therapeutic tools in here. This is a Theragun. Guys, think serious. It's a pneumatic ball that can beat into your arms. Okay, it's like basically getting a deep tissue massage, which is awesome. This thing too, Hyper Ice. So you turn this thing on, and this is just a vibrating hard ball that you can roll out on. In my bag, I got my Motive Pure, Spark Energy, any kind of protein bar that I can grab, Crucial, an Odor Gladiator. One of my favorite things on earth, this roll out here, this trigger point roller, two rollerblade balls, and then like a hard stick in the middle. In a self-maintenance league like this, you gotta take care of yourself.
Even Jack's Beast has gear. My player's dad, Tom Gibson, was really kind enough to get Jack's very first lacrosse stick from the reservation. Unbelievable. I mean, Jack's Beast will probably be a world famous DJ, but as a backup, he could probably play lacrosse. I also got one of these for him. Sarah from the ML office sent over an extra from 2 years ago, so he'll have a little memory there, which is pretty awesome, and that's what this is all about.
Landed in ATL, got here early, and then my room wasn't ready yet, so I went and saw Guardians of the Galaxy 2, which is fantastic. Couldn't possibly recommend that movie enough. It was a visual masterpiece. And now I'm just hanging out, waiting for Drew Adams, a couple of the coaches, Kyle Hartzell, Curtis Dixon to get in, and we're gonna go grab some grub.
Tonight, live from Fifth Third Bank Stadium in Kennesaw, Georgia, it's the Atlanta Blaze hosting the New York Wizards. Look at Greg Gerenlian right there. He's their big faceoff man. They call him the Beast. He's won 60% of the faceoffs he's taken so far this year. A chance to practice together all that often. So we'll see what kind of excitement we get tonight as the way faceoff is won there by Gerenlian. Runs right into the zone and gives a quick shot over to Gibson, who scores.
Quick shot right there off the faceoff. That's something with the Gerenlian with a great faceoff there. Quick feed, and you know, within seconds they're on the board.
Calgary Roughnecks in the NOL as we get a goal from Rabel. Rabel with a long shot, and he scores.
That's a two-pointer. That's a two-pointer. Rabel with a two-point.
This is just knowing your teammates. Well, a shot off the post right there by the Blaze. Break the hole, but the rebound put back in. Chris Bachlett. So Chris May back in the faceoff circle against Gerenlian. Gerenlian pushes it towards his offensive zone.
Yeah.
Rabel's going to let one fly, and he goes in. Rabel, three goals here in the first quarter.
That is a good point, Mike.
I'm sure he'd be pretty happy with that result, defense. Ball stay loose on the turf as Kelly gets checked to the turf. I mean, none of these shots really that we're seeing, the goals that we've seen up against him. And I'll spin back in the other direction. Feeds in the middle.
Oh,
Rabel,
wow.
Shot, score! Now Rabel left all alone and he scores.
It's pretty small at that point. Nice battle at the X.
Gerenlian wins that face-off. And Chris May fight for the face-off. Gerenlian with Gerenlian again.
Pick down from Kamer to Pinnell.
And Pinnell scores!
Nice shot.
You see Pinnell working around Fletcher right here. And just a nice cut.
Instead of trying to shoot a left, he tried to do an around the world.
Oh, what a sweet play by Curtis Dixon. He leads back, and a laser from Reynolds that finds the back of the net. Gerenlian and Kelly pushing each other around the faceoff circle. Grenlian walks away with the ball once again. And they're fighting for it. Grenlian finds it and then loses it. Back to a three-goal game. The last time it was this close. And it goes behind the cage. Now back to Parker. That one's in! Up in the zone at the start of that possession, which was finished by Bachman right here with a shot that just beats Adams. Great shot. I really admit this will be a bad punt. It plays off at 11, coming up on 5 minutes left, and Durian, a long shot. Nope. Rabel picks it off, and the horn sounds, and the Lizards defeat the Atlanta Blaze 14-12.
Got the W this weekend down in Atlanta. It was great getting a game in there, my final game on that field. It's funny, we've only played down there a few times, but obviously one of those was the championship game in 2015. So I got nothing but great memories of Third Bank Stadium. So we go down to Hotlanta a lot for the FOA, and every time we go down there, the fans are awesome, the parents are great, the non-hotbed areas are always so much fun because the kids really value seeing you. I think the Northeastern kids are a little jaded because they get so much access to us. So I had a great time with the fans after the game. So now we're 2-1. We're going to work on all the things that we need to improve. Great teams continue to get better throughout the year, and that's our goal. So we go into Boston. I'm really looking forward to Boston this weekend because it's such a great environment to play in. So it'll be a lot of fun to get out there and play in front of those fans one last time on a field that I have a ton of memories from. Always intense games between Boston and New York, so looking forward to that.